Hi, Cindy. How you doing?
Hi, nice to see you.
Hello, Joy.
Nice to
little microphone for you. Have a seat right here. Ah, yes, like it was yesterday, huh?
Good old days. How about that?
Boy. But actually, before the Supremes, you worked with a group called the Bluebells. As a matter of fact, Patti LaBelle.
That's right. And how'd you know that?
There was a lot of jealousy between the groups at that time. Is that right?
Well, in those days, it's really funny. We were very competitive, and there were so many girls' groups during those days. And the Supremes and the Bluebells, I thought, were the two best groups out there. Of course, I thought, being a Bluebell, that we were better.
And there was a rivalry then, right? In other words, if you were, God forbid, on the same bill, you didn't visit with each other or mingle or socialize with each other.
Well, I made that mistake one time.
Yeah, what happened?
It didn't prove fatal, actually. I think that's the reason I became a Supreme later. I wanted to see what these girls were all about, because the Bluebells always wore Bluebell trousers, you know, and we wore a very casual look on stage. Hardly any makeup, just a little lip gloss and eyeliner. Eyebrow pencil.
How many
there were four of us
four.
In those days. And I wanted to see what all the gloss and glitter was like. Mm-hmm. So I went and knocked on the Supremes' door one day. And it's funny that it situated them to call static. You know, the promoters would do this. Have two girls' groups on the show among all the guys' groups. And they would situate them right across from each other, next door to each other. So, you know, you'd see them all the time. And
please, we're trying to talk to Cindy now.
But I love it.
Can't keep that band down. What's the matter with those guys? So anyway.
Well, anyway, I went and knocked on the door.
You knocked on the
and
Supreme.
And Dionysus come in. Yes.
Yeah.
And I asked her, I wanted to see what the wigs and the makeup was all about, because they used to wear four pairs of eyelashes. Big
puffed
up wigs.
They really did it, didn't they?
That was great.
So you went in there.
I went in there, and Diana says, well, sit down. And she made up my face and put all this stuff on my face and gave me one of the wigs to try on. And I went out of the room, transformed. I went in there, one person, and came out.
Another person,
and went to my manager and said, look at this, isn't this great? He said, take that stuff off.
Sure. The Bluebells were offended, weren't they?
They were. I mean, the girls didn't speak to me for at least the rest of the day.
How come you left the Bluebells and joined the Supremes? How did that happen?
Well, that was really a difficult decision to make. I think a lot of it had to do with family and friends and maybe a little pressure from them.
Mm-hmm.
And, I guess maybe deep down, maybe a desire to be in that group too.
Maybe
the makeup had a lot to do with it.
Makeup really converted you, huh?
Yes.
Did the Supremes, they were not with this famous group until after you joined the group, right, Cindy? Isn't that when I don't remember, what record was it that really rocketed the group to stardom?
Where Did Our Love Go was the song that did it. Well, the group was at a really nice peak when I joined them.
Yeah.
Already, and they had long since left the Chitlin' Circuit, that's what we called it in those days.
It was hard work, though, wasn't it?
Very, very hard. I mean, we worked harder. The Supremes and the Bluebells also work harder than many of the guys' groups out there.
Now, what was it like wearing that whole costume and the wigs? The wigs were sensational. Did you ever lose a wig in the performance?
Actually, I did one
time. Did you really?
That's one of my funny stories that I tell sometimes. I was on stage in Jamaica, the island of Jamaica, and we had a little dance routine where everybody took a solo in those days. It was in our early career. And I went out for my little solo dance number, and I made a turn real quick, and my wig flew off right behind me on the stage, and I was standing there totally embarrassed. You know, the audience cracked up. They thought it was funny.
One of the Supremes hairless. A hairless Supreme.
So I just kicked it out of the way and just kept going.
Ah, sure.
No, it's devastating.
Can you do a few numbers? A little medley, a little taste of the Supremes from the old days for us?
Of course.
Oh, I'd love to hear it. Okay, here's some memories for you. Cindy Birdsong, Solo. And a taste of the Supremes.
Yeah.
say Bring Back. And how.
That's my favorite song, Stop in the Name of Love.
Stop in the Name of Love, yeah.
I remember seeing you at, I think it was at the Forum. Do you remember, Regis, many years ago?
Yeah.
Yes, that was really important job to us because we lived in Los Angeles at that time.
So when did the group, what year was it that you disbanded?
The group really broke up, I think it was 1979. I left in 1977.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And what has been going on in your life for the last 9 years then?
Well, I've been home with my little boy, David. Yeah. Actually, he's not too little anymore. And he really is glad that I've made this decision. You know, the desire just became so great after going to Disneyland 100 times in the last 10 years. And school meetings and, you know, just staying at home, basically raising my son. The desire came back so strong all of a sudden. I think it's because of what's happening in the music scene today. I mean, the pulse of what's happening, the center and heart of what's happening in music today really relates a lot to the 60s and the era that I came up in, you know, 60s, 70s.
So it's whetting your appetite.
So
huh,
I said, whoa, I got to get back out there again. You know,
so now you're starting the comeback, right? The career is on fire again and...
Yes, it is. I had my debut actually here in New York City a couple of weeks ago, and then the following week I went to London and I had a London debut.
Oh, exciting.
And they were both very, very nice.
That's terrific.
I was warmly welcomed by...
Do you have any trouble getting material together?
Actually, I'm going to be writing a lot of my own things, but initially I've used a lot of different writers' songs and just been gathering material here and there, whichever song I hear that I like,
you
know, if it's available and I want it, you know.
Well, good. Well, we have one number ready to go right now. We'd love to hear what the new Cindy Bird song Sound is all about. Okay?
Yes.
What is the name of this song?
It's entitled Ready for You.
Ready for You. All right. Here's Cindy and Today, 1986.
Good luck to you, okay?
Nice
to have you on our show. Right back with the fashion statement of the 80s. The